Sunday marks the beginning of Catholic Schools Week, spotlighting the value of Catholic education in the United States. According to the U.S. Conference of Catholic Bishops, 99% of Catholic school students graduate from high school, and 86% of Catholic school graduates attend college. Joining me now is Mary Pat Donoghue, Executive Director of the Secretariat of Catholic Education for the U.S. Conference of Catholic Bishops. Mary Pat, welcome back. You and I met years ago when you were the principal at St. Jerome Academy in Hyattsville, Maryland. You've seen Catholic education from all sides, teacher, administrator, now in this position as Secretariat. What are some of the unique benefits of a Catholic school education?
Catholic school education forms children in an integral manner, bringing in their faith, their intellectual development, their moral, their social development, really in order for them to be the people that God has created them to be. And then in turn to bring that formation and those skills into a world that's badly in need of that type of formative whole person approach.
Let's talk a little bit more about that, because there are so many challenges to Catholic schools nowadays. What are you think are some of the greatest challenges facing Catholic schools, and what do you think we can do to help?
Certainly, Catholic schools face challenges along the lines of financial revenue. Right now, it's a largely tuition-based model, which oftentimes means it's a burden for families who are already struggling to make ends meet. So I think it's important for the entire church to recognize the value that Catholic education brings to the church's evangelical mission, and that all of us really do bear a responsibility for that. So I think helping schools find diverse funding streams to enable them to continue their missions would be one challenge. We're always challenged, too, to effectively provide for diverse students, diverse learning needs, for example, students with special education needs, students who are newcomers to the United States, students who speak languages other than English. So all of that, too, requires resources and training. So
what do you think we can do as Catholics to promote Catholic school education to bring more young people into the church?
I think that's a very good question. And I do think that keeping young people in the church is a matter certainly of training them in the ways of the faith, but also incorporating an intellectual foundation. It's important that children understand the why from the time that they're very small, and that they begin to understand things like the nature of the human person from the time they're small all the way through. And in that way, if we feed the intellectual side and we continue to encourage them to question and provide them with truth, and full answers, then I think we have a better chance of keeping them in the church as young adults.
Such an important message. I think that's where people lose out. They don't realize that the theology, the philosophy, all need to come together with just math and science.
Completely. And from the time that they're small. You know, there's a growing number of curricular programs that that address this. We don't want to wait until they're past the age of questioning to begin to provide some of these answers. We want to begin doing that in an integral way. So certainly a Catholic education would emphasize the importance of math and science, but we would see those subjects as gateways to the wonder of creation, to stimulate in students a sense of awe and a sense of wonder. And the ancient Greeks knew that wisdom began in wonder. And that's something I think we're all called to bring back to our kids today.
Important message, and obviously Catholic education has benefited so many people over the years and decades. Mary Pat Donoghue, Executive Director for the Secretariat of Catholic Education for the U.S. Conference of Catholic Bishops. Thanks so much for talking with us about it.
Thanks so much for having me, Wyatt.